क्लास वी हैव डिस्कस्ड अबाउट मटेरियल्स एस्पेक्ट्स ऑफ सोलर कलेक्टर्स एंड डिफरेंट टाइप्स ऑफ कलेक्टर्स ऑल्सो. ओके, टुडे वी शैल डिस्कस अबाउट कॉन्सेंट्रेटिंग कलेक्टर्स एंड द टाइप्स ऑल्सो. हियर द कॉन्सेंट्रेटिंग कलेक्टर्स, इट हैज अ कॉनकेव रिफ्लेक्टिंग सरफेस एंड इट इज अ कॉनकेव. It has a concave reflecting surface to intercept. That means it will observe. Okay, it will observe and focus the sun's beam radiation to a smaller receiving area. For example, any small area. Okay, whatever the sun's radiation will fall on that surface. That surface. Okay, the sun's beam radiation to a smaller receiving area. It will increase the radiation flux. Okay, it has a concave reflecting surface, and that is a shaped mirrors, or it uses lens. Okay, they may use mirrors or lenses for concentrating collectors. Here the focus the sun's beam radiation to a smaller receiver area, and it will provide a high temperature. It will provide a high temperature when you compare it with the flat plate collectors. It has concave reflecting surface. It will collect sun's radiation to a smaller receiver area, and it will provide a high temperature than flat plate collectors. And it requires mirrors requires a clean and smooth surface, because if any dust, okay, dust will fall on that. So it will reduce observing. What happens means if mirror or lenses, dust is concentrated, it is observed. Mirror is observed dust, then it is not able to observe the sun's radiation. Okay, so a mirror should be clean and it should have a smooth reflecting surface, because dust particles could scatter light away from the receiver, or the light could be, it could be partially absorbed by a thin dirty layer. So that's why its surface should be clean and it should be smooth. Okay, why it should be smooth means because in some errors will occur if it is not smooth, because some errors that will result to the it cannot absorb the heat properly. Okay, next is selection of concentrating collector. How we will select the concentrating selector, what are the factors it depends? Okay, it depends on the mainly degree of concentration, and also it hence temperature to be achieved. Here somewhat temperature it should achieve. Okay, the main factor it depends is the degree of concentration. Here concentrating energy on a point, for example, concentrating energy on a point. On a point means it produces high to very high temperature. If it is on a line, okay, concentrating energy on a line means it will moderate to high temperature. If it is non-focusing collectors, it will produce a low to moderate temperature. These are the points you should remember: concave reflecting surface, sun's radiation it will absorb to smaller area, and it will provide high temperature. It requires a clean mirror and smooth surface, and it depends on the degree of concentration. For selection, mainly depends on the degree of concentration, and concentrating energy on a point, it will produce on a point, it will produce a very high temperature. On a line, moderate to high temperature, and non-focusing collectors, low to moderate temperature. This is the concentrating collectors. Next, classification of concentrating collectors. Here, based on means of concentration, that is a reflecting type use mirrors, or refracting type use Fresnel lenses. In next, based on reflecting surfaces used, that is parabolic, spherical or flat. Okay, you know the shape surface, how it should be. It should be a parabolic, or it should be spherical, or it may be flat. Next, continuous or segmented. Next, based on the formation of the image, that is imaging or non-imaging. Imaging concentrators may focus on a line or at a point. Okay, it may be focus on a line or it may be focus on some point. Okay, only particular point. Okay, on the basis of collectors, concentration degree or operating temperature. On the basis of collector concentration ratio or operating temperature range. Next, by the type of tracking, either it may be single or dual, like that. Okay, type of tracking. First, we shall go with the compound parabolic solar collector. Here, the non-imaging concentrating collector. This is a non-imaging concentrating collector. To make an image, all the parallel light rays should be concentrated at a single point. What they are saying is, compound parabolic solar collector. This is a non-imaging concentrating collector. To make an image, okay, this is a non-imaging concentrating collector. To make an image, what they are doing here, all the parallel light rays should be concentrated at a single point. Okay, to make an image, all the parallel light rays, okay, there are many parallel light rays that should be concentrating at single point. Okay, that should be concentrated at single point. The non-imaging collectors are the collectors which cannot make the image. Okay, image that is of sun. Okay, next, compound parabolic collector, CPC, that is it is a well-known kind of non-imaging collector. In CPC, parallel light rays get focused at two points. Here, parallel light rays, it get focused on two points instead of one. You can observe, that is A and B. Okay, the CPC is comprised of two parabolic mirror segments with different focal points as indicated. That is, you can observe two focal points A and B. Okay, the two parabolic surfaces are symmetrical with respect to the reflection through the axis of the CPC. And here the receiver tube place is AB. This is the compound parabolic solar collector. Next is a parabolic trough solar thermal collectors. This is a U-shaped collectors, U-shaped reflectors or U-shaped collectors. Next, this can be effectively produce heat at temperature 50 to 400 degrees Celsius. Okay, it can produce a heat up to temperature between 50 to 400 degrees Celsius, and it is made by bending a sheet of reflective material into a parabolic shape. Okay, it is a made by bending a sheet of reflective material. You can observe here, it is a U-shaped. Okay, it is a U-shaped. It is a made by bending a sheet of reflective material into a parabolic shape. Okay, here a metal black tube. You can observe here down, black tube. Okay, this is a sunlight, glass, vacuum and inner layer. This is a black tube, a metal black tube covered with a glass. Okay, covered with a glass tube to reduce what? To reduce the heat losses. Okay, to reduce the heat losses, it is placed along the focal line of the receiver. This is the receiver line. Okay, this orange color line is a receiver line. Okay, and it that is a trough concentrate sunlight onto a receiver tube that is positioned along the focal line of the trough, and it is a it is 50 to 400 degree Celsius. It is achievable, and it is uses single axis or double axis tracking, and it can be used to produce steam for electricity generation. In California, multi-megawatt power plants were built using parabolic trough combined with gas turbines. This is a parabolic trough solar thermal collectors. In next, Fresnel solar thermal collectors. Fresnel solar thermal collectors, here same, okay, here metal black tube covered with a glass tube to reduce heat losses, and the same point bending a sheet of a reflector, okay, that is also same points here. It is a 400 degrees Celsius, the temperature is 400 degrees Celsius, and here linear Fresnel reflector relies on a array of linear mirror strips that concentrate light onto a fixed receiver mounted on a linear tower. Okay, this is the figure of that. And next, you can use a flat or a curved reflectors here. It uses a flat, you can observe, it may be flat or a parabolic. Curved reflectors they use. Yeah, it is cheaper when you compare with the parabolic reflectors, and its structural requirements are minimal as they are mounted close to ground. Okay, in order to avoid shading and blocking between adjacent reflectors, increasing space is required, but the cost is increased. When you increase the spacing, then cost also increase. Okay. This is the points regarding Fresnel solar thermal collectors. Okay. Cylindrical trough collectors. Here, cylindrical trough collectors. Biggest advantage of cylindrical trough collector is that it does not require tracking of sun. The biggest advantage is it does not require tracking of sun. For high rim, rim is nothing but edge of an object. Okay. High rim angles, there will be a focal plane instead of a focal line. Okay, you can observe here, instead of line there is a focal plane. Design should be done with low rim angles. Okay, this is about cylindrical trough collectors. Next, parabolic dish collectors. Here it is similar to the large satellite dish in appearance, and it is a mirror like reflectors and observer at focal point. And also you can say that a point focus collector that tracks the sun into two axes. They are saying that it uses a dual axis sun tracker, and it point focus collector that tracks the sun into two axes. One is concentrating solar energy onto a receiver. Remember, concentrating solar energy onto a receiver located at where it is located at the focal point of the dish. Okay, concentrating solar energy onto a receiver located at the focal point of the dish. And the second is one axis is that one, and the what about second axis? The dish structure must track fully the sun to reflect the beam into the thermal receiver. Okay, where the thermal receiver, dish structure must track the sun to reflect the beam into the thermal receiver. Next, here it can we can say that receiver absorbs solar energy and convert into thermal energy in the circulating fluid, and this thermal energy can be converted to electricity. And the here temperature up to 1500 degrees Celsius can be achieved. Here some of the advantages of parabolic dish collectors, that is a first is the most efficient of all collector system. They are all here, it is a always pointing the sun. Okay, it is a most efficient of all collectors. When you compare with the collectors, it is always pointing the sun. And next, concentration ratio in the range of 500 to 2000, and it is highly efficient at thermal energy absorption and also power conversion system. Okay. Next, modular collector and receiver units can either function independently or part of large of system of dishes. Here, solar thermal energy concentrator is primarily used with a parabolic dish engine. Okay, actually heading is parabolic dish solar thermal collector. Okay, here you can observe the parabolic dish solar thermal collector. Okay, this is the heading. Actually, solar thermal energy concentrator is used with parabolic dish engine, which is an electric generator that uses sunlight instead of coal or any oil. Instead of any oil or coal, that uses sunlight. Okay, to produce what? To produce electricity. Solar thermal energy with the parabolic dish engine, which is an electric generator that uses instead of coal or oil, it uses sunlight instead of coal or oil to produce electricity. These are the points regarding parabolic dish collectors. Next, heliostats. Here, mirror based system, it is used to continuously reflect sunlight to a central receiver, and the collected solar energy is converted to electrical energy. This uses a two axis solar tracking mirror that directs solar energy to a large observer located on tower. Here, power tower, a field of large mirrors that follow the sun's path across the sky and concentrate sunlight onto a receiver on top of a high tower. A computer keeps the mirror aligned so that reflected rays are always aimed at the receiver. They are saying that power tower, a field of large mirrors that follows the sun's path across the sky, and it will concentrate the sunlight onto a receiver on top of the high tower. And computer, what does computer do? It keeps the mirror aligned so that what happens? So that reflected rays are always aimed at the receiver. And what about temperature here? Temperature, we have above 1000 degrees Celsius, it can be achieved. Okay. And the next class, we shall discuss about the working of practical heliostats and parabolic dish stirling engine in that different types. Okay.